So, unboxing of a Topping PA5. Black. Warranty card, user manual, power adapter. Sizable power brick. All right, so it's 38 volts, got 4 amps available. Again, just having a look at the size of this thing. That is quite the power supply. Especially when you compare it to the dainty little power amp. I find that slightly amusing for some reason. Okay, screw on barrel connector. It's keyed at the top, so you can't get it the wrong way around. It'll only fit in that way. Will not fit in that way, so we won't force it, won't try force it. But one thing for sure is that will not come loose. That's got a nice snug feeling there. What else we got? Okay, we've got the outs, just two channels, left and right. You can take inputs, balanced inputs, but two inputs as well. Plug it in and make sure it works. Standard cloverleaf plug to fit on that side there. Pretty snug as well, which is good. Yep, very easy to do that. Yeah, it's got power. And on the front here, got, well, the name, or the model number, the brand, on off, input one, input two, and a volume control. That down, turn that on, little click, and the little light pops up. Cool. Metal case again. It's like a nice silicon rubber. Some feet. The connectors look decent. Taking a look at the dimensions, it's tiny. Less than 13 centimeters wide, including the volume knob on the front and the power connectors. Well, it's not say power connectors, audio connectors. It's less than 18 centimeters. Well, you would need a bit more depth because this power adapter is not going to bend. So you'd need to at least, let's say, 23 centimeters just to accommodate the cable without really scrunching it up. It's a tiny little beastie. Yeah, and again, about just over 40 mils, including the rubber feet, excluding the rubber feet, about 36, 37 mils. Yeah, Tiny. Class D, huh? Miniaturized.